Hi! Welcome back to our channel. In this video, we will be doing an animation practice. We are going to animate a sword in a slashing motion. This is a simple exercise. It's fun to do and it's easy to follow. This lesson is actually a part of our members-only lessons, specifically the lesson FD04, and we're giving this away for free. Just in case that you want to become a member because you want to access all of our members-only lessons, then you can click the link in the description. In this video, we will be practicing using the straight ahead method. And then we're going to focus on like the spacing of the animation. The sword is first going to accelerate and then decelerate. And then we're going to add smears to the fast parts of the animation. So, let's begin. So now let's try to apply the acceleration, deceleration on a different example. And I have opened a new file or created a new file. This is 1920 by 1080 and the FPS is 24. So first I'm going to draw a samurai weapon. So I'm going to press F4. So that we could have like a bigger like screen, and now I'm gonna draw the weapon. So I'm gonna press F4 again. So I drew here a samurai sword, but you can choose whatever you want. You could draw a water bottle if you want, or a baseball bat, or a different kind of sword, a different design if you want, like a knight's sword. You choose, you decide whatever design that you want, but I'm going to stick with this design. So next is, I'm gonna teach you like a technique. I already have discussed this in the past lessons, but just to recap, we're mainly gonna use the F6 and not the F7. So if I'm gonna click this frame, and then I'm going, because we're animating on 2, so I skip a frame, right? I'm gonna click this, and then instead of F7, I'm gonna press F6. And what it does is it created a new frame, and it's like the duplicate of this. So this is the same, so I'm just gonna undo this. So F6 is the same as pressing here, clicking this one, then press F7, and then copy this. So that's Command C if you're working on a Mac, that's Control C if you're working on a Windows. And then let's paste it here. So that's Command V to paste. That's Control V to paste. But as you can see, the position is not on place, right? So I'm going to undo that. To paste on place, that would be Command Shift V if you're working on a Mac. That's Control Shift V if you're working on a Windows, right? So basically that process, those amount of steps is the same as just pressing F6. So F6 would save you time because it's just one button, right? So I'm going to undo that again. I'm going to click this frame and then press F6. I'm going to turn on the onion skin, and we see nothing, right? No onion skin here because this frame and this frame, they are basically the same drawing, right? But I'm going to press Q on my keyboard. And if I'm going to rotate this, see, you'll see now the previous frame. So I'm going to undo this. So now we are going to animate this, and we're going to apply acceleration, maintaining speed, and deceleration. But we're not anymore going to maintain speed, because what we're going to do is we're going to have this weapon like move in a, like moving this using the rotation. And the movement is too small. I want it to have that fast movement, so I don't want to bother myself with maintaining speed. And you could see here this circle, white circle, that's like the pivot or anchor point. So I'm gonna drag this now here, and then I'm going to rotate. So you hover your mouse to around like the edge until the cursor change to this icon. So once it's that icon, I could now click and drag and rotate. And we're going to use the acceleration, so I'm just gonna like have like a small spacing. So like that, right? And then I'm gonna skip a frame here, and then I'm gonna press F6. And the onion skin is only up to here. I'm going to bring it so that we could see like 2 frames, right? And then here on this frame, I'm going to drag the anchor point to back here. And then I'm going to rotate this again. Now you could see I'm going to double the previous spacing. Not here, because that would be the same. I'm going to double it. I'm going to skip a frame, press F6, and then bring the anchor point here again. And then I'm going to double this spacing. Skip a frame and then press F6. Again, I'm going to double this spacing. Skip a frame, press F6, and then double this again. So maybe somewhere around here. Skip a frame, press F6, and bring the anchor point to here, because if it's in the middle, it's going to be like that, right? I want the anchor point to be here. And then again, let's double this. So what I'm trying to show you here is that the concept of doubling the previous spacing doesn't only apply to position, but it also applies to rotation. So let's continue. I'm going to skip a frame, then press F6. I think this would be our last acceleration. So we're going to double this again and then skip a frame. Now let's decelerate, right? So now I'm going to divide this into two. Skip a frame, press F6, and divide again the previous spacing into two, somewhere around here. Skip a frame, press F6, and then divide this again to two. Skip a frame, press F6, set the anchor point here. Again, divide this into two. Skip a frame, and then press F6, bring the anchor point here, and then divide this again to two. And we're almost at the stopping point. Skip a frame, press F6, then bring the anchor point here. Divide again to two, so maybe somewhere around here. Skip a frame, then press F6, bring the anchor point here again. Divide this into two. No, this is the same. The spacing is the same. I'm gonna like minus the spacing. So skip a frame, press F6, and then again, divide this into two. This would now be very smooth. And I think just one more and we're good. Skip a frame, press F6, and then divide this to two. So what we did here is we did not anymore include the maintaining speed, only the acceleration and then deceleration. So that we have, you just like have to be consistent with like animating on twos. So this one is just one frame. So I'm going to click this frame and press F5. And then let's have a look. I don't know what's the outcome of this is. So I'm just going to press enter, and that's like the animation. So I'm not really that satisfied with the animation is smooth, but I'm not really that satisfied with the spacing because it's too slow. I think we could emphasize this a bit. I think if we remove this one, it's going to like make this like a bit more like faster. So let's do that. I'm going to remove this frame now. So I'm going to select both of these and delete the frame. So I'm going to click Shift F5 to delete the frame. And let's have a look. So I think this one here is good. But here it's again too slow. I think this frame is what we can delete to make the overall animation faster. So I'm going to select both of these and then click Shift F5. Let's have a look again. So this one's better. So we're now going to apply smears to this. So I'm gonna like create a new frame, and again we could like adjust the onion skin so we could see like the whole animation. And the fastest is, I think this is the fastest. This is the second fastest. And this is the third fastest. So let's, I'm going to apply smear to the fastest and then second fastest. So I'm going to try it out first. Okay, so let's locate this spacing. So let me adjust the onion skin that it's like only back to a small amount of frames. And let's locate that frame. So this one. So I'm going to adjust the onion skin. So this spacing. So I'm gonna click this frame and then press F7. So that will start here. And you decide what smear design you're going to use. For me, I'm going to combine the after image and the speed lines. So for here, I'm going to make it like it's almost like a sword, but I'm not going to complete the drawing. Also, we need to consider the arc. So it's not here because that would make it shorter. So consider like the arc of this. So it's gonna be somewhere here. And I'm going to like add in some speed lines. And maybe I'm also gonna add speed lines to this one. And then I'm going to, the next, like after image would have a lesser, not complete look. So the further away it is to the real image, the less complete the look is. So that's the design that I'm like going for here. So as you can see, the farther away, the more missing parts it has. And I'm going to add in here the like speed lines. Now this is already done for me. I'm going to skip a frame, click this one, press F7 so that this frame would only be exposed up to this point, not going all the way to the end. So let's have a look with just the fastest. It's going to look like that. Now I'm going to add smears to the second fastest. So we have 2 second fastest. This one, so I'm just going to adjust the onion skin. So this one is the second fastest and this one. So I'm going to do this first. So we're going to apply the same principle. The farther away it is, the less complete it's going to look. But you could always like choose your own design. If you want the elongated look, this would also work. Remember this kind of look, or combining the elongated look and like some speed lines would also work. It's going to give a different effect. The effect that I'm going for here is the after image and speed lines. And then we add in the speed lines. And now let's do the other second fastest, which is this one. And then we add in the speed lines. And then I think I'm already good with this. Let's skip a frame for this one. Let's press F7 so that this drawing would only stay up to this point and not all the way to the end. And now let's zoom out a bit and then let's preview this. And looking at this, originally I just planned to do the fastest and second fastest, but let's also try adding smear to the third fastest. So I'm gonna click this one, press F7, and let's, I'm gonna press B on my keyboard for the classic brush tool. And then let's draw in like the smear. So maybe just one after image would be good. And also to the like other third fastest, this one, maybe just one after image. And then again, let's skip a frame, then press F7. And let's have a look. Yeah, I think this one's really good. So let me just click fit in window. And don't forget to save this. So I'm going to save this now. Click file, then click save. So I'm just gonna rename this as FD-04. So now I'm gonna click save and then export this as a GIF. So I'm gonna do that, click file, click export, export animated GIF, and then click save. So this one's already good. I'm gonna click save. So this is now the output. So I hope you enjoyed our drill today. And if you like this video, chances are you're going to love our membership. So let me tell you a little bit about that, about our membership. So our membership has 3 tiers. The first tier is called the Seeker tier, and the benefit that you're going to get is you'll get access to all of the lessons in the lesson library. So currently we have two categories. The first category is the frame-by-frame animation, and the second category are the color lessons library. And as of this recording, the frame-by-frame animation library has 34 lessons, and the color lesson library has 2 lessons. And if you're watching this from the future, let's say that it's months or even years since this recording, then chances are the libraries are going to have way, way more number of lessons because we regularly post new lessons. And the idea of this whole thing is to teach everything we have, everything that we know. So we have been in the motion design industry for the past 10 to 11 years doing projects for clients, and in those 10 to 11 years, we have learned a lot. And the idea is to teach everything that we have learned, starting with frame-by-frame animation and colors. But soon, we will also branch out to Blender, After Effects, storyboarding, illustration, character design, and etc. Again, the idea is to teach everything we have learned. So currently, we have like 2 categories, right? Frame-by-frame animation and color lessons. But again, if you're watching this from the future, months or even years from now, chances are we're going to already have a lot more categories. So that's the first benefit of the Seeker tier, access to members-only lessons. The second benefit is that you'll get access to our Discord community. And we encourage all of our members to post their drills in our Discord server. And if you do post your drills or your output, then me or anyone from my team would take a look at your work or your output for those, like the lessons would have like drills, and you post those drills on our Discord server. So me and anyone from my team would take a look at them and give feedback so that you'll know what to improve upon. So to recap, as a Seeker, you get access to members-only lessons, all of the members-only lessons, the community, plus feedback. The second tier is the Pathfinder tier. So with this tier, you'll get access to all of the benefits from the Seeker tier, plus every Wednesday, 10 p.m. GMT plus 8, we are going to have a group Zoom session. It's gonna be 1 hour. So if you don't know what GMT plus 8 is, basically it's just like a time. You can Google it to know the exact time in your time zone. But every Wednesday, we are going to meet up and then have a group Zoom session. And what do we do during the session? We are going to practice drawing. So there's going to be like drawing drills. So currently, what we are doing is we are practicing drawing in the 3D space to be able to give that illusion that our drawing is 3D. Because if you're like a beginner, right, chances are your drawings are gonna look flat. So what we are currently practicing with our members is to be able to convey that form and volume, as well as practicing basic perspective. So the Pathfinder tier, this weekly sessions, this is evolving. This is changing depending on the progress of the group. So currently we are like doing like the basics, but once I see that the group is improving and have like progressed, then I'm going to introduce more and more complex drills. So this kind of like session, these are like evolving. But currently, as of this recording, what we are doing every Wednesday with the Pathfinder tier is we are doing basic drawing practices, basic perspective drills. The third tier is the Voyager tier. And what you get in this tier is all of the benefits from the Seeker tier and all of the benefits from the Pathfinder tier. Plus, every month, you can schedule one-hour session with me. So what do we do like on that like Zoom call? That would depend on what you would like to cover. So you can think of the one-on-one session as like an additional 1 hour private class that you can decide what the topic is all about. So for example, you are struggling on this part of the process in animation. We can cover that. I could explain that further or discuss that with you in the one-on-one session. Or if you want to learn something new that is not covered in the library, we could also like discuss that. But of course, that topic, I should like know about that topic, right? I mean, I can't teach if I don't know about it. But if I'm familiar with it, like let's say you saw like an animation on Instagram that was done in After Effects and you'd like to replicate that effect, then we could hop in on a call. You could schedule that you have like every month, you have like one-hour session like with me. So during the session, I could teach you how to do that technique. So the Voyager Tier is a more like customized like learning experience. You could choose that topic every month for that session. So if any of these are interesting to you, if you like this kind of learning, then you can click the link in the description, or I'm also going to pop up the link anywhere on the screen, and you could also click that. That's it. That's all I have to say for now. Thanks and keep learning.